Hey guys, Max here, and Apple just held their 32nd WWDC, so here's everything that was announced and a recap of the virtual keynote. Quick side note, I'm gonna be doing a couple of videos this week about the software that was announced at WWDC, so iOS 15, iPadOS 15, macOS 12, and others, so if that's something that interests you, subscribe below if you're not already, and let's get on with the video. It was a pretty normal WWDC announcement-wise, but they did have a couple of interesting software announcements. There were no hardware announcements, only software, but Apple spoke today about iOS 15, iPadOS 15, watchOS 8, the Home, and macOS Monterey. Let's kick it off with iOS 15. So iOS 15 now has a simplified notifications page where everything is grouped in a simpler way. And they now also have contact photos for people. So when you get an iMessage notification, there's a big contact photo so you know exactly who the person who sent it was. Notification summary is a new feature which brings a collection of notifications to deliver at a specific time in order of priority, which allows you to have a morningly briefing of notifications basically. So you can set it to like 9:30 a.m. or something and then you get all of your notifications at 9:30 a.m. so that you know exactly what happened while you were gone. Statuses now allow you to turn on Do Not Disturb and notify another person in the conversation that you are turning on Do Not Disturb so that they don't bother you anymore. And if you actually have some sort of urgent message that you need to get to someone, then you are able to bypass that Do Not Disturb and get that message right to them if it's an urgent message that they really need to see. There's a new feature called Focus, which allows your device to silence notifications and guide a more peaceful life without the distraction of your phone all the time. And FaceTime now has movie and music sharing, so you're able to watch a movie or listen to music together, as well as you're able to share your screen on FaceTime, which is also pretty cool if you're planning something or if you want to show someone something on FaceTime. Messages now have photo stacks, so if you send a lot of images to someone, then they all get kind of pushed into like one stack, and then the person can swipe through instead of having a bunch of notifications and a bunch of images. It's just like they've sent one photo stack or something like that. Memories now have a new music mixing overlay, which is also pretty cool, and Maps has an extremely detailed new UI for the map that you're looking at, and so that means that you're gonna have a lot more detail and you're able to see what you're looking at on your map a lot better. Another cool feature that they introduced in iOS 15 is the ability to point your phone camera at any text, and it basically uses the machine learning inside of your device to register what it is that you're looking at. And if it's a phone number, then you can have the option to call that phone number, or if it's text, you can have that option to maybe translate that text or copy it into a note or something. So it's basically Google Lens using that sort of same machine learning technique, but it's pretty cool, and pretty cool to be integrated in iOS 15 now and not be a separate app like Google Lenses.
And give this place a call, just like that.
Hi, Wanderlust Creamery.
Oh, whoops, sorry. Just applying a deep neural network here to a photo of your shop. No actual need for ice cream at this time. Gotta drop, bye.
Okay, let's move on to iPadOS 15. The biggest news of the day is probably that there are no Pro apps, and they did not bring Pro apps to the iPad. That was a big rumor that they were gonna bring Pro apps to the iPad, so Final Cut Pro, Logic Pro, and Xcode, and a lot of other Pro apps that Apple has in their library. They did not bring that to the iPad Pro to take advantage of that M1 chip, but they did have a couple of other big announcements. So App Library is now on the iPad Pro, which is pretty cool. There are now widgets on the home screen, so you can place even bigger widgets on the home screen now, and there are new multitasking features like a shelf on the bottom of the screen, which allows you to bring up apps and different things like that during split view, which also makes a more efficient multitasking experience. WatchOS 8 wise, there were not a ton of features that were announced. However, there are a couple of new watch faces, as well as some new health features, which allow your Apple Watch to help you even more guide a healthier life. For some tvOS or homeOS or home sort of overall, like just, I don't know, improvements for your home. They didn't really specify any name for that. You can now share what's on your Apple TV with people in group FaceTime calls, like I talked about a second ago. AirPods Max now have spatial audio with your Apple TV, so you're able to put your AirPods Max on and have that spatial audio experience, which is super fun. And HomePod Mini can be used as a stereo pair and put in like to next to your Apple TV, and you're able to play whatever's on your Apple TV onto your HomePod Mini, which I think we had before, but I guess they improved it. One of the biggest announcements of the day was Apple's new release of macOS, macOS Monterey. Monterey does not change the visual interface of macOS as much as Big Sur did, but there are a couple of changes of how your Mac works. So there's a feature called Universal Control where you're able to use just one trackpad or mouse and one keyboard, and you're able to use that to control all of your devices. So if you have an iMac, or if you have a MacBook Air, or MacBook Pro, or Mac Mini, or an iPad Pro, you're able to control all of those with a completely universal control. Shortcuts has also come to the Mac for the first time, and Test Flight for Beta apps is also now on the Mac. Safari redesign is cleaner and simpler and more efficient, which is super cool. That's why they redesigned it last year, but this one is even flatter and even simpler and even nicer. You can now also AirPlay to Mac, so you can AirPlay what's on your other devices onto your Mac as if it was a TV. WWDC was a super packed show, but that's been it. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.